Hi and welcome to this edition of Out the Box. My name's Paul. Today we're going to be looking at what is in this box. Move that out of the way. It's a 20 kilo box. I'm not going to lift that up. What is it? This is TP-Link VIGI, sometimes said VIGI. This is actually their solar array. This is a really interesting product. I think there's going to be about three or four of these in the range. We're looking at the SP9030. It's around about 18 kilos totally in weight. We have a 90 watt solar panel here, all right? And then we have a just over 30 amp hour battery, which is in this. Those combined will give us a number of 12 volt outputs and an RJ45 connector to connect this up Ethernet, and gives us an opportunity all in one to have a very simple solution that we can use maybe where we need to get some cameras that we don't have power near. Maybe we needed to do a wireless bridge and we need to repeat that signal somewhere along the track as well, again, with no power. So I can't really show you this all put together, but I am just gonna show you the components that make this up. We will have another video on our YouTube of this all fitted and actually how it works, but hopefully this gives you an idea of all the items that you get in the box. So to start with, you're going to get a installation guide. Shows you a whole lot of things, obviously how it all fits together, but the right angles to maybe look for the solar panel as well. You are going to get a whole packet of screws and bolts there. You're going to get some larger bolts here to actually bolt the solar panel onto this setup, which I'll show you in a moment. You are going to get your post mounting brackets, two of those. It should be possible to also mount this straight to a wall, maybe with your own bolts and washers. I'll show you that in a minute. It is mainly designed to be put onto a post. You're going to get what we might call a waterproof lid. There is an RJ45 connector on this, and this would allow you to pass your Ethernet cable through this if you wanted to keep that nice and dry. I'll show you about that there. You're also going to get a couple of bits of conformity documentation as well. Right, then you're going to get the three main components. So like I said, in the model that we've got, you're going to get a 90 watt, I think it's an 18 volt solar panel. I'll maybe show you the front of that and show you maybe if I can, see if we just, let's just turn this around and you can see on the back here, mounting bracket of how it joins together. So this sits above all the other items that I'm going to show you now. Then you get basically the main stem. This is got your battery in. So like I said, I think you probably could wall mount this here using some washers if you wanted to, but the idea is that you're going to take your post and these are actually going to go through like this. So inside this housing here, if I turn it around here, is actually our 30 amp hour battery. So 30 amp hours probably isn't massive, but if we're only gonna hang a camera off this or maybe a bridge, we've maybe got potentially a day and a half to 2 days with no solar for that to actually keep running. So it is a good useful solution. We've got a bunch of indicators on the side here just to show you how everything is going. All right, and then really in the end, this is the interesting bit to me. Obviously, you can see the battery enclosure in there. We've got an Ethernet cable. So if you do have a bridge device out on this spot and it's got a spare Ethernet port, then you can connect this and this whole thing can then be remotely manageable. Get your statistics back for how the battery is going and everything else. So this one here is actually going to go up to your, this one here is your connected to your solar panel. So I got that wrong. That's going to go up to your solar panel. Then you have your Ethernet cable here. All right, so we could use that plastic lid that we had at the moment to seal it. This could go to your wireless bridge if it was set up on here. And then obviously this would then be able to see the internet. So you don't have to connect this to make it work. Obviously this could just be standalone and maybe you've got wireless around and you're just gonna hang a wireless camera off it. That will work okay. And then on this model, you actually get three 12 volt output connectors. All right, even one here just with a connection block at the back. Hopefully you can see that there as well. All right, so you've got varying options of what you have for your connectors. So we can have a bridge on here, a couple of cameras, makes it really, really versatile. So we then have, so above this is where our solar panel will come, sitting on here, this to your wall. or your post with your solar panel. And then we'll have our stem that comes down here. So all of these cables will come through the bottom of this. Let me show you, so if I can just tidy those in there and show you what they're actually going to look like. All right, so this is going to be our main stem. Not even done that right, have I? Those actually need to go through the bottom of this bit here, which is hopefully just try and do that so you can see. I'm just going to pass these. Now again, because there's quite a lot of hot screws and stuff drilled on here, there are quite a lot of options available to how you may decide to mount your own equipment on this. But your cables are going to come down through the bottom of this, then they're going to come through into your other bracket, and this is going to sit on the bottom like this. As you can see at the bottom here, so I'll remove it so you can see now, you've seen how that fits together. As you can see, we've now got a lot of different mounting options. So this is vertical. We've got a lot of different screw hole interfaces here that we can put bridges, other brackets, zip tie to it. And we then get a turret mount option here. So we obviously get the ability to put this on here. And again, we can now fit any of our standard style zip tie or cameras that want to need to hang directly onto the bottom of this. And so maybe a 360 camera or something like that that's going to hang on the bottom. So we get some quite great versatility in how we can mount this. Like I said, you might decide that you've got enough screws on the bottom of here and you can mount directly to that and don't need this stem. But I think that this opens the opportunities up for this not to just be other TP-Link. We probably use this in some other manufacturers that we use for their wireless bridges that maybe are only going to consume 5 or 6 watts of power. And we are looking for a simple, easy battery solution that we can ship to a customer. They can plug the Ethernet into one of the spare ports on the bridge, and we can therefore get internet access and see how this is going. And then maybe we've got a camera hanging off this as well. But in most instances, this maybe is just going to be used as a simple repeater. So I reckon this has great potential in the market. This is the top end of the range at the moment. Like I said, this has got a 30 amp hour battery in it. It's got three 12 volt connectors, your Ethernet connector if you have a device that can also connect back over the internet. Otherwise, you're going to hang your wireless camera off it or whatever. And this is going to power it for as long as it can, based on the wattage of your camera. So hopefully that's been helpful and useful to show you what's in the box. Like I said, do look at some of our other videos. We are going to put those up shortly of how this performs and how we were able to fit other pieces of equipment to it. But if you're looking for a simple solution for an all-in-one solar panel that will run, just needs to be set up and screwed in place and put your devices on it, this could be it. So this is the TP-Link VIGI SP9030. Head on over to our YouTube channel. We've got plenty more box openings on network, wireless and firewall devices. Like I said, plenty of things on how to run network VIGI, TP-Link VIGI as a camera system, how all of this connects together and works. So why don't you head on over there, subscribe and stay up to date.